card from my side and let me share the screen. And SSMS alt tab, Kusuma said alt tab to see all open tabs. Good. And Chandrakant, SSMS, okay, fine. Muthu Kumar, control plus T to show the plan text in SSMS. Very good, Muthu. My computer mic is not working. So, okay, no problem, no problem, Kusuma. Thank you for the info. Seventh is service info. Okay, good. Service info. Service info, what it will do, Seventh? Can you explain, please?
So it will show all the details about the like configurations and the CPU or how the memory is how much memory it is.
That means you are going to type in the search bar as service info?
In the run command.
The run command, service info. Okay, let me check that one. Service info.
System info.
This is how it is going to load, but why I cannot see it was closed immediately. That's okay, that's fine. Okay,
now it will get saved in the desktop, I believe.
Saved on the desktop. Okay, let me check that one. Refresh. I don't see any file, any temporary file will be created. Percentage. No, any recent file will be created. No. Okay, that's fine. Okay, might be. It will generate, might be it was depends on system to system. Okay, so in case if you want to see system information, there is a shortcut MS Info 32. Okay, MS Info 32 will help us to find out the system information. This is how you will get the output, Shravanti.
Yeah, got it. Yeah,
okay. MS Info 32 is the shortcut for that. Okay, and computer name, okay, and number of CPU cores, physical memory, right? So this is a shortcut. Okay, fine. And a lot of beautiful shortcut keys are there. Very helpful, guys, for me as well. Okay, I'll save this text, okay? And almost all 10 to 12 participants participated in this shortcut. Okay, that's fine. Very good. Okay, good number of shortcuts. Thank you, guys. Let me connect to the SQL Server. First of all, it was stopped. Let me start it. Nothing to worry how to start and all. I'll explain later, okay? If my SQL Server is stopped, then I cannot connect, guys. If it is up and running, then only I can connect. So I just started the service. Now again, I'm trying to connect. I'll explain about this window. There is a special class on my Management Studio. During that Management Studio class, I'm going to explain this. Okay. What is this tool and all, right? And you can see the bill number here. This is all our bill number, okay, which will help you to find the version of the SQL Server, right? And if you go to the properties of this instance, this is instance name, guys. This is instance name and the version and who connected to this instance name. Okay. Who connected to my instance? Right click, go to properties. There you can see, okay, where you can see the SQL Server version, guys, other than this. It will also show you here 15.0 only. You cannot see 2019. If I want to see 2019, where I can see the 2019. Okay. See here, guys. I can only identify this version as 2019. How? By using this build number 15.0. But I just want to see this is a SQL Server 2019 instance. How can I do that? That is an assignment question for tomorrow. Okay. Right. Very good. Okay, fine. Right. Okay. So already we got the answer. We'll discuss about that as answer tomorrow. Fine, guys. So let's go with this. Okay, Verma. Thank you, Chandrakant and Verma. Let me go with this one. Right now, everyone is comfortable with the versions, SQL versions, Windows versions, and compatibility levels, guys. Very good. Control panel is also one option. Guys, is it clear compatibility level on which version of Windows servers I can install SQL servers? Clear, everyone? Comfortable? Any issues, any doubts?
Yes,
okay. Very good. Okay. Let me continue now. Editions of the SQL server. Okay. So we discussed versions of the SQL server, versions of the Windows server, build number, CTP, RC, RTM. Okay. And compatibility levels of the softwares. Now let's discuss about the editions of the SQL server. What are the editions? Right. Edition is nothing but limitations to the features. You can call it as a edition, guys. Limitations to the features. You can call it as a addition. Okay, let me mute all. In case you have any questions, you can unmute and let me know. Right. Limitations to the features, you can call it as a additions. Okay, we have different additions in the SQL server. Means what? Clear example is a matrimony site. Okay, matrimony site. If you go to the matrimony site, what happened? Okay, so there are different plans. Right, silver plan, basic plan. Let me open it for you. Not login or what? Okay, forget about it. No issues. Okay, why to waste the time and all? Okay, fine. Okay, that means if you go to matrimony site, okay, there you can see different plans: silver plan, okay, gold plan, platinum plan. That means, see, for example, matrimony. Might be Bharat Matrimony, okay, contains all the information, okay, contains all the information, but what they will do depends upon the account you are using. Okay, they are going to unlock the information, means they are going to unlock the features. Agree, everyone? Right, he will collect that matrimony site management will collect the whole information about the brides and bridegrooms. Okay, but depends upon the plan you choose, they are going to give you the features. Agree, everyone? Is it clear? Means even though features are there, they will hide some features. If you go for silver plan, what happened there in the silver plan might be you will get only profiles. Okay, and if you upgrade it, might be monthly, you will get 10 contacts or 20 contacts so that you can call to them, you can ask them, you can just have a discussion with them, right? If you go for a gold plan, in the silver plan, it is 10 contacts per month. In the gold plan, might be just giving a sample, guys. I don't know any idea about this one. Gold plan, if you go for gold plan, might be you will get 50 contacts, but silver plan cost is 2000, gold plan cost is 5000, okay? As you are paying 5000, now you are unlocked with some extra features. Platinum plan, 20000. Okay. Means unlimited contacts you will get, unlimited profiles you will get, unlimited horoscopes you will get. Okay. So that means the amount which you are paying depends upon the amount you are getting the features. Agree? Means the whole features will be unlocked if you just completely bought the package, or if you just invested only some amount, only some features will be unlocked. In the same way, we have features, okay, editions in the SQL server, guys. We have different editions in the SQL servers, okay? And these are the famous editions. Express edition, free edition. See, guys, now also I can go to the matrimony site, I can create a free account. What is the use? Simply, regularly, daily, morning, 6 o'clock, I'll get all profile photos and their names, nothing else. Their names, profile photos and age, that's it. I might be location. In case if I want to get the information, if I click on any photo, automatically it will ask us to, okay, what it will ask us, please upgrade your account. Then only I can see, I can collect that information, right? That means free means you will get the features, okay, but you cannot use the features. Okay, guys. So in the same way, we have free edition in the SQL Server, which is Express Edition. For my free account, for my pre-matrimony account, like how limitations are there, in the same way, Express Editions are also having a lot of limitations. Okay, you don't get agent, SQL Server agent. This is the agent, guys. This will help you to run the jobs and all. This is one service, SQL Server agent. Okay, this will help you to automate the things in the SQL Server. This will help you to automate the things in the SQL Server. Okay, so in the Express Edition, you don't get this one. Means in the Express Edition, you cannot automate the things. You cannot automate the backups. You cannot automate the restores and all. It's very difficult, right? Without automation, who will take the backup regularly, daily? Or in case I want to take log backup we generally took for 15 minutes, every 15 minutes. Who will log into the server every 15 minutes and who will take the log backup for every 15 minutes? If there is no agent, that is the challenges. And max database size also in the Express Edition is 10 GB only. You cannot create any database with more than 10 GB in the Express Edition softwares. And you cannot, the biggest limitation is you cannot use that Express Edition software in the production environment. Express Edition, you cannot install. It's illegal on prod environment. Why? Because remember, guys, on prod environment, always you have to install licensed versions only, licensed editions only. Free editions, you cannot install on production environment. Clear, everyone? Is it clear, guys? Clear? You can understand.
Yes.
You can, yeah. Okay, clear, right? So that is how Express Edition will work. So Express Edition is a free edition, but having a lot of limitations, right? Limitations in terms of database size, limitations in terms of features, limitations in terms of environment usage. So it depends upon the environments, depends upon the license you are using. Okay, you can install your servers either on prod or non-prod. So Express Edition, you cannot install on prod environment. You have to strictly installed only on non-prod environments. Like we have dev. See, guys, prod and non-prod. These are the two environments in the organization. So production means real-time live servers. Production servers means live servers, means the application will be directly connected to the live servers. Non-prod means stage servers, dev servers, test servers, QA servers, UAT servers. Okay. So these are the different non-prod or pre-prod. You can call it as a pre-prod or non-prod environments we have. Means whatever they want to introduce, whatever feature they want to introduce on live servers, before doing that, first they will introduce on non-prod servers. Once the feature looks good, it doesn't create any noise, then only they will introduce that feature on live servers, which is on production servers. Okay. So this non-prod servers will help us to test the logics and all. Okay, guys. So only on non-prod servers, only on all these environments, you can install Express Edition, guys. Okay. You cannot install Express Edition on live servers. It is illegal. Okay. Microsoft, you can ask, sir, how Microsoft knows. Okay. Microsoft will conduct audit, guys. Every year, yearly audit will be there. Microsoft will come to the company. They will conduct audit. They will run some PowerShell scripts. They won't check directly, go to the server. This is licensed or non-licensed. In that case, they will take 1 year, okay, for the whole company itself. Okay. They will go to the company. In case if I am the customer of Microsoft, they will come to my company and they will check. They will run some PowerShell scripts across the company and they can easily find out, how many versions, how many editions we are using, what and all editions, everything in the audit, they can find out. Once they find out in the audit, it's illegal. They will impose 10 times, 20 times fines. Okay. So that's very important, guys. You cannot install Express Edition on a production environment. Okay, guys. Right. In the same way, we have different editions. Evaluation Edition. When compared to Express Edition, Evaluation Edition is having some extra features. Okay. But it is free for only 180 days. Means only 6 months it is free.
Yes. Shanmukh, I have one question in Express Edition. Yes. Mm-hmm. So you said some size limitations, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is applicable to all
yes,
the SQL versions, right?
Mm-hmm.
From the starting to till date, next new releasing also.
That might be policy can be changed. See here, earlier Express Edition is free, okay, up to SQL Server 2016. developer edition is not free. Okay. See, okay. Up to 2014, Express Edition is there. Express Edition is used. People also use this Express Edition. But what happened from 2017 onwards? Okay. What happened? Developer edition, the Microsoft, okay, gave this developer edition is also for free. So when compared to Express Edition, developer edition is also having a lot of features. Okay. So people stopped using this Express Edition. Now you may not find out for the future versions, this Express Edition. Okay. This Express Edition.
So till latest 2019, we have this Express Edition, right?
Yeah, okay. We cannot say like that. Okay. So okay. We have developer edition. Might be it is there, but no one is using. Okay, why? Because this is free edition. If you want, you can use this developer edition, which is more features when compared to Express editions. Okay.
Okay.
So this is also free only. But what happened? This is less features, and this developer edition is having more features. This is free from SQL Server 2017. Okay.
Okay.
So who will install Express edition for SQL Server 2017 as my developer edition is free?
Yes.
I'll prefer developer only, right? So you might not see that Express edition for 2017, 2019 and all, as developer edition is free.
Okay, fine. Okay, thank you.
Okay, yes. Right? Yes.
So the maximum size for that is 10 GB, right?
10 GB. For Express edition, that is 10 GB. And again, guys, okay. No one will ask you what is the maximum size for developer edition, what is the maximum for its standard. It's just for our understanding purpose, okay? That's it. In the interview, they don't ask these questions. Sure. Okay. Tell me the differences between standard edition and enterprise edition. Okay. We cannot tell why, because almost all, both are same only, but capability is going to be increased in the enterprise edition. Okay. Right. I'll explain. Right. Evaluation edition is free for 180 days. That means 6 months after 180 days, either you have to upgrade or you have to remove it. Evaluation edition. Next is developer edition, guys. Developer edition up to SQL Server 2016, you have to pay money for developer edition. For developer edition is also, you have to pay money, not small amount. You have to pay $4,000 for each copy. Okay, depends upon the server course. But what happened from 2017 onwards, okay? What happened, Microsoft, okay? So they just made this developer edition as a free edition. Lot of amount saved to the companies, guys. Lot of amount. Imagine lot of amount saved. Imagine one software copy is $4,000. In my organization itself, we have migrated almost all, okay, 800 servers. We have migrated to the 2017 developer edition. Earlier also developer edition only, but 2016 developer edition. For 2016 developer edition, we have to pay the money, $4,000 for each. $4,000 means what? How much? Almost 3 lakhs Indian currency. Okay. So you have to pay 3 lakh rupees for each copy every year. Imagine 800 into $4,000. How much? Okay. So that much of amount we saved. Okay. Simply Microsoft, what they did, they just announced that developer edition is free from 2017. So lot of companies saved lot of amount. Because of this developer edition, guys, it's a very beautiful edition and all the features are free and there are no limitations at all. Might be, free edition, you cannot install on production environment. I told you, right, every time there is a thumb rule, free editions, you cannot install on production environment. Okay, if it is free itself, you cannot install on production environment. It's illegal. You can use this developer edition on non-prod environments. Okay, clear everyone? Is it clear? From 2017 onwards, means 2017 developer edition is free, 2019 developer edition is also free. Fine, guys. Is that clear? Can I proceed now? Right. After that, after this developer edition, we have one more edition called standard edition. Okay, this also can be installed on production, non-prod also. Standard edition, you can install. There is no limitations for standard edition. Standard edition, you can install on production and non-prod also. Okay, and then finally, enterprise edition, guys, very important edition, okay, very costly edition, enterprise edition. Enterprise edition, see, enterprise edition, you can install on non-prod also, no issues. Why? Because I have more money, lot of money, I don't know what to do, then install enterprise edition in your non-prod environment. No one will ask you in case if you're installing enterprise edition on non-prod, this is how sometimes mistakes will be there, guys. Okay, people, those who are freshers and all, or else those who are worse. In some companies, other technology people, Oracle DBS also will work as SQL DBS sometimes. If there are no SQL DBS resources, Oracle people has to work as SQL DBS. What they will do, simply they will install interpretation on the non-prod environment. Then the company has to pay money every time. Company also don't detect in case if any manager, team lead or any DBA, okay, they took the responsibility and they just checked what and all environments, non-prod environments installed by the interpretation. Otherwise, company don't know this one. Simply you're wasting the company's money, $4,000, 3 lakhs of the company. So interpretation, it's not illegal if you install interpretation on non-prod environment, but on production environment, you have to use enterprise edition. Either enterprise or you have to go with the standard edition, very costly edition, enterprise. All features are unlocked. Okay, there are no limitations for enterprise edition, guys. Other than this, we have a lot of editions also there. Data center edition is there and different editions are there, but these are the famous editions that are there in the market. Clear, guys, that are going to be used in the market. Clear? Everyone is clear with the editions. We will have Express Edition, Evaluation Edition, Developer Edition, Standard Edition, and Enterprise Edition. Enterprise Edition is the highest edition which we are going to install on production environment. So on production, 99% servers will be Enterprise Edition only. Everyone, any questions, any doubts, please?
What is the difference between standard and enterprise?
That's what. Okay, if you ask the standard and enterprise, might be there is a difference in terms of hard disks. Okay, in terms of database sizes, the two not small database sizes and all. Very big. See, standard is also supports big databases. I'm not saying it will support only small databases. But might be when compared to standard, enterprise will support more storage and all. Okay. If you still need, sir, I want point-to-point difference. Go to Google, differences between standard edition and enterprise edition. You can check it, what and all. Why? Because we don't need it and no one will ask you what is the difference between standard edition and enterprise edition. And we cannot remember also. A lot of differences will be there. But not minor differences, as I said. Not major differences you can see. Minor differences you can see in terms of capability and all.
So Shanmugh, if you said like standard edition, it is useful for development databases. Okay, so for enterprise edition, we have production databases. Mm. So for while of testing, we are going to refresh the prod to non-prod.
Yes, so is there any kind of no issues you can get it. Okay, it depends only on version. It doesn't depend on editions while restoring or refreshing databases. Okay, it depends only on you're restoring from higher version to lower version, it will accept. Okay, but you're restoring your production environment is 2016, your non-prod environment is 2019. If you are trying to restore, in that case, it is not possible. Any version, any edition, this is thumb rule. Okay, higher to lower only you can restore. Lower to higher is not possible to restore. Agree?
Okay.
Clear? I'll explain, guys. Nothing to worry. Okay, fine. So is it clear, guys? Editions, everyone is clear with the editions of SQL servers?
Yes.
Right. Next is components, guys. Once this is done, then we'll jump into the demo. Okay, so nothing to worry. Once this is done, we'll jump into the demo, guys. Right. Components of the SQL server. When you install SQL server, along with the SQL server, we will also get different components. Okay. So if you want to install SQL Server, you have to install this component, guys, database engine. For example, if you buy any food, there you can see components in the food, right? If you buy any food, you can see what are the components are there in that food, right? In the same way, please note it. In the same way, when you install a SQL Server, we can select some of other components also. Database engine is must. Database engine is the brain and heart of the SQL Server. Earlier we discussed, right, SQL Server is a database software which helps you to store the data, process the data, retrieve the data, right? So to do all these things, your database engine is going to be helpful for us. SQL Server means database engine. On behalf of SQL Server, one database engine will be there in the backend and it will run. Like how car engine is important for the car, how brain is important for us, in the same way database engine is important for SQL Server. If you install multiple copies, multiple database engines are going to be installed. Without database engine, there is no SQL Server, guys. Okay, this is the component that is going to be help us to store the data, to process the data, and to retrieve the data. This is one component. Along with this component, you will also get access to these business intelligence development studio components, bids. You can call it as a bids. Those who are trying for, okay, business analyst and all, usually they will use these tools. These are the different tools that are offered by the Microsoft. Okay. If you want these tools, then you can install these tools also. While installing the SQL Server, we will have a chance to select the features. In that case, if customer is asking, I need only SQL Server, you have to install Database Engine Services. If customer is asking, no, I want SQL Server along with analysis services also, then there is an option, analysis services, you have to select that analysis services. Analysis services will be installed. I need reporting also. Okay, that's fine. No issues. But guys, extra services means extra money, guys. Don't think on all the features I'll get in the same pack or same amount. Only database engine, that is the license cost. Okay, if you need analysis, reporting, integration, extra money you have to pay. Okay, extra features, add-ons, you have to pay extra money, guys. Okay, so these are the three different tools that are offered by the Microsoft, especially for the business data processing and all, okay, to analyze the data, to process the data, right? Extra company, extra money, yeah. Okay, and to integrate the data from different sources, guys. Guys, you will all have experience. Everyone will go to the either more supermarket or Reliance. Everyone will go to those stores, right? Srevante, I have a quick question for you as you are from US. So if you go to any supermarket there in the US, they will ask you the mobile number?
No, they don't ask.
They don't ask, right? They cannot ask, right, actually?
Yeah, I didn't notice, but they don't ask any mobile number, but they ask sometimes the card, they will provide a card, membership card, right? They'll see that and they will allow us in the market.
Yes, very good. But here, guys, if you go to any store in the India, see how policies are there in the US and India. Okay. In the India, if you go to any store, even if you go to visit your friend in the apartment, they will ask your mobile number and all. What they will do, you know, there are special agents, those who will collect your information from all these sources. You know, your mobile number is going to be sold every day. Okay. So you will get lot of opportunities, lot of calls, lot of messages. You didn't give your number to anyone, but how? Your mobile numbers and your information is going to be sold. If you are going to more supermarket, even though you don't need, they will ask your mobile number. They don't need actually. What they will do? They will simply keep an eye on you. How many times you are coming? They will process the data. How many times you are coming? What things you are purchasing? Simply more supermarket in the Bangalore, lot of locations, it is there, right? So what they will do earlier, they don't know. It's very difficult to identify, okay, where is the business is down. Okay, now once this mobile number feature introduced, what happened? Based on this mobile number features, they are like scrutinizing the data. They are processing the data. And okay, in this location, in the KRPuram location, Bangalore, business is dull. So who are all there in the KRPuram? Who are all our customers? Send an offers to them so that they can increase their business. Agree? Earlier, they have to introduce the offers all over the country, all over the state, or all over the city. But what happened once they just started collecting your data, they processed your data. Okay, and they started introducing offers, individual offers to you. If you go to any store, not only big stores, small shops also, they will ask your mobile number. Guys, don't give your mobile number. Simply in the store also, more also. Okay, reject. I don't want to give mobile number. Why? Because again, there are some people, those who will buy your mobile numbers daily. Those who will buy your information daily. Okay. So if you go to the saloon shop, guys, a big saloon shop, if you there also collect, they will collect the mobile numbers. You know, if you have any issues, okay, if you are black, okay, or else, so, I'm sorry, I'm just to explain the situation, okay, again, your mobile number will be sold to any, these companies will be there, right, colors and all, if you are, like, if you are having weight, okay, again, your mobile numbers are going to be shared with the particular colors. These are the different companies that are offered different services. If you have bald head, again, you will get messages from hair transplantation companies and all. Right? So that much, that is not the way people are using. Please mute it. Right? So in that way, your mobile number is spreading, guys. You don't know, like simply you don't know what things are going on. Okay. But really, at least 10 to 20 people, your mobile number is going to be shared daily. They are simply selling your contacts. That's it. It's a big fraud. Don't give your number to anyone, guys. Don't give your number to anyone. You know, this is what information is wealth. Information is wealth means this is the same situation. Okay, so your information is a wealth, guys. Okay, so don't share your mobile number even more supermarket worst. That is, I'm not promoting any supermarket chain, but I'm saying, okay, even you don't get any big offers, but still they will ask your mobile number and all simply to send the promotional offers and all. Okay, so just simply reject. And in case if anyone is sharing, just educate them. Okay, fine, guys. So how they are doing all these things with the help of this analysis services. Okay, they are going to analyze the data with the help of reporting services. They will generate a reports. Okay, beautiful reports and all they are going to generate. Okay, where the business is dull, where the business is good, they are going to generate beautiful reports and integrate. They are going to integrate the data from different sources, from different RDBMS to means Oracle to SQL Server, you can load the data. SQL Server to Oracle, you can export the data. Okay, on Excel sheet to SQL Server, you can load the data. From SQL Server to Excel sheet, you can upload the data, export the data. Okay, means from different data sources to SQL Server, you can import, or from SQL Server to different data sources, you can export the data, guys, by using this integration services. These are the add-ons. If you want, you can buy these features. But customer will tell you, user will tell you, I need these features or not. During installation, they will tell you. If they don't tell anything, simply you have to install database engine services. If they tell, oh, hey, I need analysis services also, then you have to select analysis services. Okay, so while installing, I'll show you how to do that. Is it clear, guys, everyone, till now? Any questions, any doubts, please?
So for integration services, if in future, if anybody asks us to install that separately,
yes,
we can
very
do that, right?
Very good question. In case if I install only SQL Server now, in future, anyone asks, hey, please install integration services. Might be that instance is installed by some other person for 1 or 2 years back. Now he is asking to install another component. We can happily do that. After 2 years, 10 years also, in case if that instance is there, you can install. Okay, so Nokraju, you asked how to identify companies broad and non-broad. Nokraju, once you go to that company, they will tell you, you have to ask your colleagues what are the servers are there, how many servers are there, what servers are production servers, what servers are non-prod servers. Okay, depends upon the company to company, guys. There will be a notation, okay, how to identify the production. If you ask, sir, how to identify the production, how to identify non-production. See, this is how the server names will be. Just a sampling purpose, I'm saying. In case in my company, I want to like tell my company server name. Like imagine I'm working for a Amazon company. Okay, I'm working for Amazon company. So Amazon company, how database servers will be there? Imagine, I'm just saying it's a sampling. Okay, it's not like a real server name. Application name, it will include in the server name, AMZ. Okay, next is, if it is a database server, which database server? Is it Oracle or SQL? SQL. Okay. Right. And what this server?
Look, I believe in 1 minute it's going to end.
Yeah. Thank you for that. Let me reopen the meeting, guys. Thank you so much. Please join immediately with the same link.
Yes.